Hello YouTube, this is Darkon633, back with another Super Sentai review. Today we're going to take a look at the Uchu Sentai Kyuranger Deluxe Saiko Kyutama. Now this is the main Kyutama that's used by Lucky to transfer into Shishi Red Orion, which is his powered-up form. Now what's really cool about this device is that it has the sounds and features of the main Kyurangers before Koguma Sky Blue, Ryu Commander, and Ho Soldier, but other than that, it's got all the other main Kyurangers featured on the device, which is really awesome. Before anything else, we're going to take a look at the box. The box is a little bit of a unique size. It's a little bit of more of a full-on boxy style rather than the flat rectangular style. It does have a lot of cool artwork around there. And on the top, it shows the main Kyurangers there. Bottom is pretty much just the Japanese text. On the back, it shows the features of the Kyutama and so on and so forth. So now, we're going to take a look at the Kyutama itself. On its own, you actually have a few sounds, but it's not going to have a lot compared to what we've seen when attached to the Seiza Blaster. But anyways, to turn it on, you do have an on and off switch, which is really nice. And it's got this really cool confirmation sound. It's got a few sounds here. So first,
what's up?
So it actually says, what's up? So I find that really awesome that it actually says that. It does have a few other sounds associated with it, following up with that. So first, we're going to go through the spin, which will activate a sound. So here we go. And that's pretty much a generic sound you're going to get on this device. But continue on. It does actually have a few planets in this mode. So first, that is Mercury. And to activate it, you just spin it. So it actually just recycles the sound over and over with the different planets, but that's pretty much just the basic attack sound. So next, we're going to take a look at Venus. Continuing on, we have Mars. Next, we got Jupiter. And finally, we have Saturn. When you press it again, it's going to recycle back to the first sound. So that's cool. And the cycle continues. Before anything else, here is a comparison of the Saiko Kyutama next to a standard Kyutama. And as you can see, it's exceptionally bigger by quite a lot. The regular Kyutama are a little bit more of a hand-sized device, while this one you kind of need to hold with two hands in order to get it fully in grip. So now, we're going to actually bring the Seiza Blaster and look at the sounds with that device. And now that we have the Seiza Blaster here in screen, we're actually going to attach the Kyutama. Now, you actually do not need to actually have the actual Seiza Blaster in order to activate the sound, since all it does is just hits this button there. But to make it more accurate, we actually are going to use the device. So here we go. It connects like normal. From there, you just spin it. And that's it for the generic sound. In order to fully transfer into Shishi Red Orion, you do need to press the button. It has that confirmation sound, and then so that's really awesome. If you activate it just by spinning it down, it's going to do the generic sounds over and over again. In order to activate the other sounds, you need to press the button a couple times. So first, we're actually going to press it. That's Shishi Red Star. So what we're going to do is spin. The next one is Saucery Oranges. Followed by Okami Blue. Galaxy! Next, we got 10 bins.
Trick spawn. 10 bin galaxy.
Followed up by Oshi Black. Next, we got Hibatsukai Silvers. Continuing on, we have Chameleon Green. Next, we got Washi Pink. Then we got Kachiki Yellow. And then finally, we have All Star, which is just all of them together. That pretty much finishes up the main sounds of the device. However, you actually get three additional sounds when you hold onto the button. So first, you hold onto the button.
Hey, it's a go! Battle Orion.
So with that, it actually summons the Battle Orion. Next, we're actually going to go with Seiza Docking. So with that, it actually forms around Battler. And the last one, if I remember correctly, actually is either the finisher of the carrier mode, or it's the summoning of that mode. I'm not quite sure on this one. And with that, it finishes up the sounds of this device. When you actually use the actual control panel, it doesn't do anything, actually. And most of the sounds are pretty much all based on the button and the actual ring around it as well. It does actually have the full-on sound when you pull it off, though. So that covers my review for the DX Saiko Kyutama. In terms of functionality, you're definitely going to get a whole lot out of this. And since this device is just around or a little bit below 3,000 yen, it's definitely worth a pickup, especially if you find it in places like Amiami, Angel J, or any of the online retail stores. I definitely recommend picking this up since it does have a lot of features going for it compared to every other Kyutama in the line, even the Sun and Moon one, which I can't remember on the top of my head when it was. But I think Bandai did a fantastic job of this Kyutama, and it does have a lot of play value overall. Anyways, please kindly subscribe and check out Hero Club and Hero Taku. Also check my Twitter, DarkCon633, and don't forget to check down the other channels down below. Please check the little bell at the bottom of the screen in order to see my content go up as soon as possible. I'm back with more Super Sentai reviews, but for now, I'll be seeing you later, YouTube. Bye.